The headlines a couple of weeks ago was about South Africans' xenophobia. Now it's Nigerian students in India. And this one is as a result, apparently, of a 17-year-old Indian who apparently had a drug overdose, and allegedly the drug was supplied by a Nigerian. And basically, some Nigerians, the police arrested Nigerians and later released them. And after they were released, all hell broke loose, and they've been attacked, mobs. Some of them have been threatened and are still being threatened as we speak. What do you think is the best way forward for this, considering the government, in terms of the government and handling this particular situation?
First, I would like to say that the present situation we find ourselves in presently in South Africa and also in India is our own doing. And Nigeria has, when we elected a new president, we thought we were going to show strength to the rest of the world. Of recent, a Chinese importer imported fake tires. Nigeria didn't go to the street to start attacking Chinese. There have been so many cases of investors, foreign investors, foreign individuals in Nigeria doing or engaging in illegal business. Nigeria never for once attacked foreigners for that. And for us to have been attacked, and this was the same excuse I was given also in South Africa, for us to have been attacked because an individual was allegedly said to have. See, that is preposterous. Well, for the case of India, I'm very, very happy because most prominent individuals in India have actually stood up against and castigated the action. That is good. The media is also doing a wonderful job there. That is good. Same also in South Africa. In South Africa, that has not been the case. That's been very, very...
I think it's been a bit more positive, if I can use the word, more positive in terms of response with India. Even some of the students who are from the school, that's the Greater Nordia School, have also aligned and support the Nigerians who have been attacked.
I think that's a good... But for Nigerian government need to show strength. It is very important for us to sign a note of warning to every nation that we will not take an attack on any Nigerian. See, we are a country of 180 million people. I think we don't understand, we don't appreciate the population and the strength we carry on. For us to be the giant of Africa, well, probably I'm not saying probably maybe in practical times has not really been fruitful for the past few years. But notwithstanding, we still remain the first point of call for every individual that wishes to come to Africa.
But don't we have our role to play as well in terms of how we are perceived in the international market? The issue of drugs and trafficking and all the other negatives seems to be a reoccurring issue. But then again, are we the only country that does this?
Until we have an investigation and it shows that they actually took the drugs from Nigeria over there, then we can now start looking at our border issues. But that is not even the case now. If an individual is found guilty or caught in the act for any activity, illegal activity, first thing you should do is to arrest all the individual and try into the proper process.
You mentioned the arrest because the police arrested the Nigerians and later released them. If they were guilty of
they wouldn't have released them.
So there seems to be
so for people to now pass on the road because they are Nigerians, of course, probably maybe it is true they might have probably done it. It is unheard of. Oh, because I feel and I don't like the face of an Indian, I start attacking Indians in my neighborhood, or start attacking Englishmen in my neighborhood. It is not done.
Let's look at the face-off between the Senate and, of course, our president, PMB, who there seems to be this major face-off between President Buhari and the Senate, especially on the issue of confirmation, the latest of which is the INEC RCEs.
Again, I will say, for the National Assembly, they don't get a lot of things right. We've been calling for a lot of so many allegations against them, corruption-related allegations. We've been having the reclamation for openness. I want to know what they are getting. But notwithstanding, I will not sit here today and tell you that I will wish for a National Assembly that will act as a stampede to the presidency.
But that seems to be the Senate seemed to be very upset. And this was born out of the fact that President Buhari and the whole issue of Ibrahim Mago as the acting chairman of the EFCC, despite their reduction, the president is still basically going ahead with that. I think that was the bone of the contention.
Now,
so everything that comes from the presidency now is met with a roadblock.
Yes.
So the question now is, how does one navigate this? Because two elephants are fighting. and the grass is suffering, so to speak.
well, to me, I would say, like I said, I will not advocate for that. But notwithstanding, we should understand that the Senate on its own is an entity, is an independent entity on its own. And return is taken now, it shows that it is not being regarded by those in the executive, and it shouldn't be so. For the Senate to have summoned the Controller General of Custom, and he said he cannot appear. After he made appearance, they told him, Mr. Man, you are holding a particular office. We want you to appear in the uniform of that office. Mm. And you are telling the Senate you cannot appear. And you still deem it fit. First, you are taking the private jet allocated to that office. You are making use of it. The allowances and the salaries agreed to the office, you are making use of it. You are enjoying the benefits of that office. Mm. And to put on the uniform, I've seen individuals take up jobs in Lagos as last-mile officials, as CAI officials, and they put on the uniform of that particular agency.
No, agreed. To me,
for the president to have accepted that, you understand that? For the president to have accepted that, because it shows that the presidency is okay with such arrogance against the National Assembly.
But what is the genesis of it? That's the question. What's the genesis of this? Because there's still an issue in court to determine whether or not he is bound to actually wear that particular uniform.
Anybody can go to court. I can decide to go to court. See, there are legal processes that you can use to slow down issues. Mm. There was no court case when the issue started. It was first based on individuals that custom officers going to shops and shooting people, getting so-called band rights, and also the ban on vehicle importation and the custom vehicle license and the rest. So these are things that came, and they said, "Okay, Mr. Man, come here, come and explain yourself." And you're telling me you can't come in your uniform. I only feel that the National Assembly and the executive should come together and work out the relationship. Well, notwithstanding, the executive must respect National Assembly as an independent body on its own. It's very, very important for democracy to move on.
All right, Bola Dale Adekoya, thank you very much. We'll be back after the break. The issue of the high rate of suicide, depression. What are the tell signs? How do you look out for it? How do you avoid some of these things? We'll be back after the break on Robin Mind. Stick around. Well, say, let's dance now. It is my turn. Just